Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now today I'm going to talk about zinc, which is an amazing mineral, and one of my most popular videos about this topic has caused a lot of great comments and questions from the viewers. Now one of them being, what's the best type and form of zinc? Now when choosing a zinc supplement, you'll probably notice that there are many different types available. Now these various forms of zinc impact health in different ways. So let me quickly go over some of the most popular different forms of zinc that you find in different supplements. The first is zinc gluconate. Now, it's one of the most common over-the-counter forms of zinc. Zinc gluconate is typically often found in cold remedies, such as lozenges or nasal sprays. Then there's zinc acetate. Like zinc gluconate, zinc acetate is often added to cold lozenges to reduce symptoms and actually speed up the rate of recovery. Then we have zinc sulfate. In addition to helping prevent zinc deficiency, zinc sulfate has been shown to reduce severity of acne. And then we have zinc picolinate. Now, research suggests that your body can absorb this form better than the other forms of zinc, including zinc gluconate and also zinc citrate. And then we have zinc orotate. Now, this form is bound to orotic acid and one of the most common types of zinc supplements on the market. And then finally, we have zinc citrate. Now, one study showed that this type of zinc supplement is as well absorbed as zinc gluconate, but has less bitter or more appealing taste. Again, if you're going to be doing lozenges. Now, again, the most popular zinc supplement is zinc gluconate because it also happens to be one of the cheapest and one of the less absorbable ones. Now, I personally believe the best and most absorbable form is zinc picolinate. And this is what I've, used in my own supplements. Its patented form comes in a clinical study one. It's called ZinMax Zinc Picolinate. So that's the one I suggest using, zinc picolinate. Zinc also comes in capsules and tablets and lozenges and sprays. I believe that capsules are the best because they have the least fillers and they can be veggie caps, so it's easy and convenient. You can even take them apart if you want. They also come in nasal sprays, have zinc, but they've been linked to a loss of smell and should be avoided. Now, one thing to note is that when you take zinc, you should also take copper with it in the form of a 10-to-1 ratio. That means like 10 milligrams of zinc for 1 milligram of copper. A good zinc supplement should also come with a copper because zinc by itself will create a deficiency in copper and will accelerate graying of hair. Now, with that said, take a look below in the description area about one of my most popular videos about zinc and the biggest benefits of all, about improving your hormones, which means increasing your testosterone levels, decreasing DHT, the hair loss hormone, lowering estrogen, the man boob hormone, and also increasing your thyroid levels, which increases your metabolism, and finally helping to lower stress levels, cortisol, again, when combined with other supplements. So take a look at that next video. There should be a link in this video or one right underneath it, right here on YouTube in the description area. As always, thanks for watching and have a happy and healthy day.